So then the next challenge is to keep track of all the lumber pieces that I have to cut to length for the trommel, as well as the aluminum braces. So you'll notice that I use labels, which are nothing more than objects. You can just create them quickly. You can just come up here and say, I want to create, and I want a skinnier line. Let's see, where are some lines? So for a line, I want to reduce the, make it thinner. And then you can put whatever label you want in it. We can go with, let's say, Roman numeral. And then change the font size, bold it, make it small so it'll fit, make it smaller. There, make it smaller. All right, so, I mean, that's all a label is. There's nothing magical about it. But it helps me to keep track of the pieces. I need to know what the total length is, so when I go to a lumber store, I can take with me a list of all the pieces. So this would be the item 5. So if we move this over a bit. And it says 5A, but it's actually just item 5. There's two parts of this dimension. So it's a 2x4 by 65 inches. Since there's two of them, the total is 130 inches. And then I just add that all up, and then this is my shopping list. So when I go to the lumber store, I need 4 10-foot by 2x4 pieces. And then I was just gonna buy 1 8-foot 2x6 for this project. And then when I cut the pieces, I'll actually label on the piece, I'll write on the piece what it is. So 5A, let's say it's this guy right here. You kind of notice that my drawing depicts the motor on the left side, but here I actually put it on the right side. Well, when I was working on building it, I was assembling it while it was upside down, which kind of confused me, and I put the motor on the wrong side, but actually this side actually works for me, so I kept it. I didn't update my drawing because my drawing got me as far as I needed to. I just needed to assemble it, have something that's functional. So that's as far as I took it. But when I cut my lumber, I'll actually write on all four sides whatever ID I've put in my drawing. So when I do the assembly process, I know where the part goes. So cutting the lumber is a very quick process. I'll show you the type of saw I use, but in the end, you'll have a pile of pieces, and if you don't put labels on them, it becomes a challenge to figure out where the piece goes.
Aluminum braces are used to add structural integrity to the trommel frame. There are two sizes, a 12-inch and a 6-inch. Both 12 and 6 have two orientations. Type A orientation is when the mounting tab is on the right side, and type B, the mounting tab is on the left side. The same is true with the 6-inch. So starting with the 12-inch, you start with 12 inches of the aluminum extruded stock. You make a 45-degree cut along this edge right here. And then you make a second cut along this edge right here. If you would like to learn more about the rock washer and the rock trommel, then please click the link above to see the next video. Thank you for watching.